The presentation of the Medal of Honor to Sergeant First Class Paul Ray Smith places him firmly in an elite category of national heroes. It's a distinct honor that his wife, Birgit, acknowledges with pride. But if she had a choice...
I would give everything back, including the Medal of Honor, to have my husband here with us.
They met in Bamberg, Germany, where Paul was an army engineer. Shortly after, he left for Operation Desert Storm. According to Birgit, by the time he returned, he looked at life differently, especially when it came to his soldiers.
He was a very tough soldier. Yeah, I wouldn't want to be one of his soldiers. But though, on the other side, Paul was a very warm-hearted softy.
As a child, Paul grew up in Tampa, Florida, where by all accounts, he always wanted to be a soldier.
As he started getting older, you know, people would say, well, what do you want to be when you grow up? And he'd say, I'm going to be a soldier.
In high school, where he studied carpentry, he was already in touch with values he would embrace in the Army.
He would say, I'm going to be a soldier, I'm going to join the military, be a soldier, I'm going to get married and have children. And it was like, those were his goals.
Operation Iraqi Freedom found Platoon Sergeant Smith deployed with the 3rd Infantry Division's 11th Engineer Battalion, where he confronted the unknown challenges of war in a hostile land. When he died on April 4, 2003, his actions were later described as extraordinary heroism and uncommon valor. Paul Ray Smith, age 33, husband and father of two, gave his life to save others.
There were two soldiers. One of them was IE7, like Paul's rank. The other one was a chaplain. And the E7 told me that he had bad news. And I said, what? And he said, Paul is dead. And I told him, I said, are you sure? Our last name is so common. Maybe it was a mistake, you know. And he said, ma'am, I wouldn't be here if it's not 100%.
Today, the Smith home is a family-sized tribute to their fallen soldier, a man they say who loved the Army and did what he had to do.
This country could use a good hero to look up to. And I don't mean baseball players. Sorry, I don't mean basketball players, and I don't mean football players. The man that put his life on the line, now that's a hero.
The family knows that having Paul recognized as a national hero won't bring him back, but it does make a difference.
With the Medal of Honor, Paul's going to go into history. His name will never die.